According to Catherine Kemigabo, the HIV/AIDS focal person in Kabarole District, most of the youth who were started on medication have since dropped off.
Because that age of 10 to 24 is a dynamic age and it's a vigilant age. Some of them go to look for jobs. If they are girls, some of them go to look for jobs in cities where they serve as housemates. Some of them run away because they get married. The boys also get into relationship. And when they go into relationship, they don't want their spouses or their friends to know that they are on drugs.
Kabarole District has a total number of 27,731 people living with HIV/AIDS, with women accounting for 16,707, while men are 9,664. 1,360 children are also living with the virus. The records at Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital also indicate that a total of 789 males cannot be followed up for their medication, while women are 1,002 for the months of July to September 2019. According to the authorities, the problem has worsened in the recent days, with 280 youth not returning for their medication to the health facilities. For example, between the months of July and September last year, a total of 1,791 clients on drugs had stopped coming to the health centers to pick their drugs.
We have done what we call community refilling. We call them, if they disclose and tell us they are here, we are in position to take their drugs. Because some of them are getting challenges of transport, and especially during the lockdown, some of them had challenges of fearing to come to the facilities because they thought we had more COVID cases in facilities.
So at 31 years old, Editor Kasangaki, a team leader at Yawe Girls of Hope Foundation, an organization taking care of single mothers who are living with HIV, contracted the disease at 9 years of age. Kasangaki, who is a mother of three and married to her discordant husband, says the contributing factor driving most of the young people away from medication is stigma and discrimination.
Does not help is the, also the government is discriminating those who are living with HIV. Not even the government, even the society itself, it discriminates. Because whereby you find that a girl has moved from here to Kampala, looking for a job as a house girl or a babysitter. But when the boss knows that this person is living with HIV, automatically that boss will sack, will chase you away, that is fearing to infect her children.
Records at Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital on HIV/AIDS performance for 2018-2019 show that the number of people who were on ART had reduced from 8,179 by the October-December quarter to 7,988 in July to September 2019. The same records indicate that the retention rate of HIV/AIDS patients for the same period reduced from 91% to 82%. Catherine Kemigabo says this has since been revived and the numbers are now back at 92%, although they still have challenges with the youth taking their drugs.
We see ourselves doing fairly well because we still want to be at 95, but we see ourselves at around 92, meaning that we still have some people who are not taking their drugs very well and they are very low, it's not suppressed.
The authorities, however, say they have introduced some interventions to solve the problem, including taking the drugs to individuals. Kemigabo also reveals that they have introduced differentiated service delivery model where youth living with the virus form groups, then take turns picking the drugs for all the members.
The problem that we have, you find that also we have no money. We have no capital and we are not educated. So you find that you don't have even money to buy pads. You don't have money to feed for the babies that we have.
Report by Jonan Tusingwire for the news in Kabarole District.